So the last area we want to talk about here of the complete boil water circuit is the condensate system. We need to maintain good corrosion control of the condensate lines. That's the steam being condensed after operations or after being heating, or whether it's being producing electricity with turbines. What we need to do is to prevent a low pH due to the presence of carbon dioxide. So we kind of neutralize that acidity that's coming from carbon dioxide. However, we have to also consider, is there any oxygen present in the steam or condensate system? And if there is, it's going to cause pitting attacks. So we have to address both of those. The most common, of course, would be the carbon dioxide. Let's talk a little bit about that. Here's the type of corrosion you can get on a tube. It's literally just like a river of condensate passing through with low pH, and it tends to dissolve, literally dissolve, the steel, copper, steel lines, or if it's copper, copper lines that are in the system. So what we need to do with being able to prevent this low pH in the condensate system is to neutralize the carbonic acid. That's carbon dioxide as it dissolved in water, forms carbonic acid. The same thing as you have in your soft drinks. There's a lot of carbon dioxide there, and that produces carbonic acid. And that's why it's low pH on a soft drink. They're down in pHs in the neighborhood of 3, 3.5. So we don't want to have that happen, of course, to the condensate line. So you have to be able, looking at the two ways of being able to control it. If you've got a lot of carbon dioxide coming into play, it means a lot of alkalinity coming in by way of the feed water, you should consider a de-alkalizer. De-alkalizer is a mechanical means of being able to, using ion exchange, is being able to convert the alkalinity to chlorides or sulfates, depending upon how you operate, mainly chlorides, and removing that alkalinity before it gets into the boiler. Now, if you don't want to do that type of thing, you can then use, of course, like most people do, they use neutralizing amines that react with the carbonic acid, the carbon dioxide, and neutralize it and raise the pH. Now, neutralizing means will not protect against any oxygen corrosion. So you have to consider, if you do have oxygen corrosion, what do you have to do in place of that? So let's talk first of all about de-alkalization of boiler feed water. What it does, of course, is take the alkalinity in the makeup water, that's the bicarbonate alkalinity, and the heat destroys it and produces carbon dioxide. Then when that goes over with the steam, of course, and it starts condensing, the steam comes down and forms liquid, of course, condensate. The carbon dioxide dissolves in it, it drops the pH and makes it a low pH and very aggressive. So we need to neutralize that carbon dioxide. The most common technique we utilize today is to use three different amines. And why do we use three different amines? First of all, these three different amines are usually morpholine, cyclohexylamine, and what we call DEAE, or diethylaminoethanol. Those are excellent products to be used, and often, of course, they've been used for years and years and years, but often are used together. But first of all, the amines are added to the boiler, and the steam carries those amines over with the steam, so they get into the condensate that way. So you're adding it to the boiler, and it goes over with the steam. Now, you can blend all three of these together and then try to protect your entire crew, your condensate system. On the other hand, if you have a system that has a very short steam line and condensate line, you may get by with just one or two of these. And we look at how to use these things effectively. Now, morpholine has been used for years, and that's been one of the most reliable neutralizing amines we have. Cyclohexylamine, of course, has been also very, very effective. And the new DEAE is probably the newest type of thing we've utilized. But how do we tell which particular amine we would like to use? Well, we talk about what we call, for these amines, a distribution ratio. The distribution ratio of the amine, it says how much is remaining in the steam to what is in the condensate. So if you have a high distribution ratio, that means it stays in the steam longer and gets to the extremities of your steam condensate system. If you have a low steam, a small system, short system rather, the amine with low distribution ratio condenses early in that condensate. So how do you rate these different things? So here's how they're rated. The distribution ratio of morpholine, it comes down very quickly, and where you're starting the initial condensing of the steam, and that's where it protects your lines against corrosion. If you want to protect the extremities for long runs on the steam condensate line, then you have to look at something like cyclohexylamine, and you see that distribution ratio is very high, and it'll take it way, way, way out. You might say, well, look at ammonia way down at the bottom, and that's a 10 distribution ratio, and that would, yes, it would be carried extremely far in the system. That's why it's not being used that often, because it doesn't come down early in the system where many of the steam lines, of course, do. So we use the DEAE, and that's the one that goes between the morpholine and the cyclohexylamine to give us protection early, middle part, and extremities of your system. So you have to look at all these, and there's a variety of different means that it can be utilized. However, if you do have oxygen corrosion in your condensate, what can you do to prevent that? Well, first of all, stop it from getting into your system. Certainly not going to come in by way of the boiler. Why doesn't it come in by way of the boiler? That's because the boiler is usually done pretty well with your oxygen scavengers, etc. But where do we get the oxygen in the condensate system? Well, remember, when steam condenses, it basically pulls a vacuum. It pulling a vacuum on in that steam line and that condensate line. So any places where it can actually be pulled into the condensate system is where you're getting it. So the best way, of course, is to stop any in leakage that may be coming of oxygen. Now, if you can't do that type of thing and you do get oxygen coming in, how can you protect against that? Well, you've got to coat the condensate piping with an oily type film, which we call filming amines. The filming amines, of course, that are utilized, and here's one very common one, there's others that are very being used currently as well. Octadecylamine or octadecylamine acetate is a very, very common filming amine. Now, these filming amines cannot be going into the boiler because they don't carry over with the steam, so we have to inject them into the steam line itself. That, you know, that's a little bit of a problem there, number one. Number two is, how do you control the dosage? And sometimes it's very hard to control the dosage, so filming amines are not used that often. We'd rather remove the oxygen or reduce as much carbon dioxide as we can before it gets into the boiler system to produce the carbon dioxide. However, people have been using a combination of the neutralizing and filming amines. When they were used together, they help each other and do a much better job, of course, for giving good protection against carbon dioxide and for oxygen corrosion. So what we have to do with the steam, first of all, let's take a look-see at the steam. What do we need to do to identify what quality we need in boiler operation? First thing we need to know is say, okay, the identity of that steam is it for heating only or is it for driving turbines? Well, if it's for heating only, then we're not critical on steam quality. But if it's driving turbines, we need to have low silica in the boiler water and no carryover, so we do protect, of course, the turbines. Well, if we have both going on at the same time, we certainly need to do a much better job of protecting those particular systems that are using the steam. So if it's turbines or if it's critical process equipment, you must have good quality steam.